these reports come from, who they come in the existence. They don't come from the heavens. If you study the Indian legal history, on the day of the advent of the Indian constitution, there were high courts in this country. The oldest high court being Madras, Bombay, and Maria, the chartered high courts. Other high courts came later, and four high courts came later. They were created by the letters made and issued by the Crown of Prof. After the coming into existence of the constitution, coming into the course of the constitution, some of the high courts were created. These courts were created by the law and made it valid. If you recollect, let's give you once again. Article 225. Obviously, by legislation. The authority to create a high court is exclusively vested in the parliament. 1978 of the list 1, 77 or 78, just check it out, as well as 78. Except the government's own source. So this authority is exclusively vested in the parliament, not in any state of legislation. So when the Article 25 speaks about the Constitution, the Article speaks about the High Court, the existence of High Court, and this Article 6 talks about the High Court created, constituted under this thing. It presupposes the making of a law by the Parliament, creating, constituting the High Court. But what is meant by this constitution? To the parliament, they must decide that they shall have a so-and-so territory. It is jurisdiction extension so-and-so areas. That is the first thing. Where is the head court to be located, the seat of the head court? That is something to be determined. On what date the head court shall commence functioning is something which is part of the constitution of the head court. These are the ingredients. You are all, at least the youngsters, the students sitting here, but you know it's a matter of history. For the older generation, we had gone through it, we had endured it. In fact, my own lifetime, the Telugu speaking people of the present state of Andhra Pradesh, we have seen what happens. We were born in a state where the capital was Madras, now Chennai. Then the Andhra state was formed in 1953, the Andhra state had Karnataka was at a very place in the old Madras province. Capital was at Karnataka. Then after the state's reorganization, Andhra Pradesh was created, merging the party Hyderabad state and Andhra state. Became Andhra Pradesh, the capital was at Hyderabad. In 2014, there is a matter of recent history with which all of you are acquainted. Once again, the whole state of Andhra Pradesh was bifurcated into Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. The capital should get through Europe. historic changes, the history of the past, the parliament, creating the new state of Andhra. Then the parliament declares that provide met the act and elaborate arrangements with respect to the High Court, said as from the first day of January 1956, or such a clear date as may be appointed under subsection 2, there shall be a separate High Court in the state of Andhra, even after the High Court of Andhra. So the date was specific, as from the first January 1956, or having been adopted by the Legislative Assembly of the state, been submitted to him, appoint by notification to the official gazette a date earlier than the first day of January 1956 for the purpose of subsection 1. In other words, the parliament declared that there shall be a separate High Court for the state of Andhra effective on 1st January 1956. Or in the alternative, an earlier date could be fixed on the state of Andhra passes a resolution to the effect. None of us have, we can't wait for the 1st January 1956. We want it on the 1st January 1955. The legislature passes a resolution, then there will be a date of that. Nothing happens, the legislature doesn't pass a resolution, the president doesn't do anything. That show the operation of subsection 1 from 1st January, it has gone to take a vote. That's a bigger regulation. Who will construct the building or who will appoint the judges, all those things are mentioned in the later portion. Next thing is the location. Subsection 3 of 1953 Act said, this is the law. The date or if an earlier date appointed, date mentioned in subsection 1 is 1st January 1956. Or if an earlier date is appointed in the official district, governor and the speaking of the constitution is the minister on the advice of the cabinet. You know that part of the constitution. He was given the authority to determine the location. So much of care was taken in this law. I may also tell you, there will go back to the check. In the recent past, after you people started watching the Indian history, around 2003-2004, two new states were created, Jharkhand and Chhattisgarh. Parliament made two separate laws. Laws are related to the Bihar Bihar Federation Act and the Madhya Pradesh Bihar Federation Act, by which these two new states were created. And each of these enactments contained the provision that on and from the appointed date is the date on which the act came into force in those insofar as those two laws are concerned. The law declared, the law of parliament declared, as and from the appointed date, there shall be a separate High Court of Jharkhand and Ranchi, or Chhattisgarh, a separate High Court of Chhattisgarh and the law was carried out. So the date of the commencement was known, declared by the law, the location of the court is declared by law. And the jurisdiction of these courts is also declared in the 1953 Act, Section 30, said the High Court of Andhra shall have in respect of the territories for the time being included in this state of Andhra, the territories of this state. And there is incidental things, what should happen at the scene of the 215 and so on. Now, we are talking about the rule of law of the Indian Constitution. What happened under the 2014 Act? What is the law meant by the Parliament and what happened in practice? In fact, what happened? I have read out two relevant provisions. Section 30 of the 2014 Act, the Andhra State, Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act, by which two new states were created. Section 30 says, on and from the appointed date, that is 1st October 1948, the High Court of Judication at Hyderabad shall be the common High Court for the state of Telangana and the state of Andhra Pradesh, till a separate High Court for the state of Andhra Pradesh is constituted in 214 Constitution, 1931. When you say till, it's an indefinite period. What is the period of which the new wave of transmitting distance is not specified under this section? Not necessarily. It could be specified under some other section or some other part. It's not mentioned. Then, the other relevant program, the other models of idea are operating for the IT1 says, subject to the provisions of section 30, there shall be separate high court for the state of Andhra Pradesh, given after report of the High Court of Andhra Pradesh. And the High Court of Andhra Pradesh will have a match of the High Court of the state of Telangana. So, subject to 30, what does that say? Till it is created, the High Court shall be a common High Court. When does the till come, the one is cited. Now, as you have seen in the 1953 Act, the date was specified under the Act with a clause that an earlier date could be chosen. Such a power was conferred expressly by the statute by Parliament on the President, subject to a recommendation of the Legislative Assembly, a resolution of the Legislative Assembly, a clear delegation of power to the President of India. Such a provision is missing under the 2014 Act. Now, what happened in practice? I'll come to it later. I think one more subsection will go this year. Now, the date is one problem. The location of the High Court. The principal seat of the High Court of Andhra Pradesh shall be at such place as the President may, by notified order, appoint. So, power is delegated about the location. The President is authorized to determine the location of the High Court, seat of the High Court. This is the law. Under the doctrine of the rule of law, this must be implemented. The same must be determined. Now, what happened in practice? How we have complied with or not complied with the doctrine of the rule of law in this case? The date is, the law is silent about the date, as I told you, till the High Court is constituted. The only body which would have determined the date is Parliament. Yes, it could have determined itself, as it did in 1953 Act, on and from the first date of January, or it could have delegated it to President and Governor to delegate it, which neither of the things happened. In the absence of that, the President of India issues a notification, I think most probably in the aspect of December or January, the President of India issued a notification, aspect of December, I think. Saying that the High Court shall start functioning from so and so date. Where does the President get this power? I didn't understand. He is not authorized. Obviously, some secretary, deputy secretary, must have appropriated the whole record. Sir, 1953, the President issued the notification to the High Court. He issued the notification in 1953 because he was authorized to issue a notification in 1953. And there was a resolution. Actually, the commencement of the High Court was much before the first time the deputy secretary High Court at Guntur. It was preceded by a resolution of the House. Only it's something like, the reading the headnote with the full text of the judgment. The President issued a notification saying that from so and so date the High Court will start functioning. I don't know what authority of the government or the Constitution of the President. It is essentially the function of the Parliament to determine that day. Unless it delegates, it will delegate. It doesn't specify the date. A way term till it's constituted, it shall be from the High Court of two states. Nonetheless, the notification was issued. The motion was from a grand ceremony, as I said, the High Court is commenced. Of course, the few planners all over the High Court. Now, welcome to the address of the Andhra Pradesh, you will be going to vote. All this kind of stuff also, except the rule of law. Now, the second aspect about the seat. We have seen under this provision, subsection 2 of 31, the principal seat of the High Court shall be at such a place that the President may by notified order appoint. The President did appoint. No. The problem is this. The notification given was the end of May 2019. Obviously, till the notification comes, nobody in this country knows where the High Court. can't legally be known.
The grand announcements you have made in this country, you know, saying that the building a five-star airport at Andhra, building that thing was publicized.
Young minds. If for theory, the President of India said, I don't have to go out of the day, I have to go out of the day, I have to go out of the day, what will happen to the theory? Apart from those critical questions, is it compliance with the rule of law? The law says, President was determined, and only then the government can come there. You start constitutional thinking that it is proper to start constitutional thinking much before anything happens, or 3 years or 2 years before, what happened, what constitutional rule is, how many things come into the government's story, and then what we do. There are the question of the rule of law. This test failed. The result is we have today a report. Of course, is there something to tell me? I have enough flack of view received in the last 2 years saying that I'm not a very good son, but I'm okay with this as long as I can give up my speech and spread it out to all. These are the facts standing on our case. These are the facts on the card staring at us. And the worst part of the story, of course, is I published an article that you guys before. Formally inaugurated, quote unquote, because in my view, what kind of inauguration was I going to call? Nobody responded. They might not have agreed with me, they might have demolished my project, they would have said something. And somebody in the government, somebody in the judiciary, absolute stone silence. This is the moment to say, I don't lose anything, I get my pension. The point is, since we are studying the constitution and the laws, this is how it happens. Unless we are eternally vigilant and watching the book, what is happening, everything might look wonderful on paper. But in implementation, what is the ultimate test is, rule of law is meant for the benefit of the people, for the happiness of the people. Therefore, there must be serenity in the law, there must be a clear prior obligation of the law, I told you. No. This may not directly affect individuals, but if this kind of laxity is permitted to go on, tomorrow there will be other bars which are equally shabby and equally lopsided, which might affect your personal liberties, your life, your property, anything. That is the danger. Now, this lacuna which the court was created is curable. If somebody is applies the mind, it's not incurable. Even today, Parliament can make a retrospective amendment to the law, determining the date and also the location. They can amend it and then recognize the whole thing, at least giving you the semblance of the rule of law. Even that nobody is willing to do. It's all right. So somebody is saying something, you don't answer it, you don't think about it. Yet, we claim on Korea that we are a country governed by the rule of law, we respect the constitution, we go above and beyond the constitution, get photographed, and big building pictures about the constitution and the rule of law. But in practice, what we are doing is this. Now, there will not be any bad intentions, and not the intentions. It's not the good intentions that matter, it's the act which matters. Intentions are a different matter. But then you claim to be a society governed by the rule of law, a society regulated by a written constitution. And all those who hold a public office in this country, a constitutional office, starting from the president to the advocates, governors, ministers, everybody, the oath is that I shall uphold the constitution, holding the constitution is faithfully implementing the text of the constitution, as is subject to the interpretations of the highest court.